All right, guys, down here at the base camp, getting ready to cook up a little breakfast. Today I'm going to be doing something a little extravagant. I've got eggs, hash browns, bacon, onion, and I'm just going to kind of combine them all into some type of a, I don't know what you'd call it. You can't possibly take all those ingredients and make something bad, so. Let me get this fire going so that's good for cooking. And then we'll begin. I'm really just using split ash for this fire. And I don't know if the wood isn't fully cured or what, but it's not burning great. So some of these pieces that I thought I would be able to just throw on, I'm going to split down a little bit more. All right, check out the little cooking fire. Split ash, started off with some feather sticks inside. So now really all I gotta do is keep feeding some stuff inside of it to make sure that it stays burning good. Thanks, Mudge.
Zach.
All right, guys, down here at the base camp, cooking up a marvelous
looking breakfast. Look at all the color in that thing, boy. Brown, hash brown.
Got bacon, hash browns, onions, and an egg. Man, does this smell good. Before I get to chit-chatting, let me have a little bite.
You hear that crispiness? Get your little hash brown, little bacon, and a little egg. Little egg, little bacon, little hash brown.
Wow. Better than I expected. This is the breakfast of a champion right here. Hash browns are nice and crispity like I like them. Usually I scramble my eggs, but I felt like this time I wanted to try something different with the yolk intact. So you get these big old, man, you get these big old nasty looking spoonfuls of food.
Look at that grossomeness. Look at that campfire cooking bowl.
Looks nasty, honestly, but it's phenomenal. Got some bacon in that bite. A little bacon. Man, that's good.
Look at the browning on them things, bowl.
Ah, dang it. See it? All that browning. Look at that, man. So I cooked one egg, about 3/4 of a potato, russet potato, and 3 pieces of bacon. And about 1/4 of an onion. And this is probably not a huge meal. If you're doing some car camping, you can bring lots of good food like this, then you can definitely make a huge breakfast for a bunch of people doing this type of thing. So good. Got some sticks and twigs back on the fire. That way it's not smoking me out. I learned that. Once you get done with your breakfast, don't be lazy. Build your fire back up again. And then the flames for the wood, if the wood's gonna burn, then it won't smoke as much. So you don't want this stuff just, the embers and the coals just smoldering. That's why you get a bunch of smoke everywhere. So save a little bit of dry wood to get on there for post cooking. So like I said, one egg, 3/4 of a potato, about 1/4 of an onion, 3 pieces of bacon is a good sized meal for a growing boy like myself. Perfect inside the frying pan. I mean, you guys can see when I was cooking, just enough space for this thing to be doable. It's not the lightest thing you could ever do, but you know, if you want to eat like a king when you're out in the woods, it's up to you. Using my little Calphalon frying pan, this is probably about a 7 or an 8 inch frying pan. So it's perfect for one meal like this. I did toss a little bit of butter in it to get it started, but I don't think you'd ever have any issues with this thing sticking. The onions really add another dimension of flavor. So if this is interdimensional flavors, we got onion flavor, bacon flavor, hash brown, butter, eggs, at least 5 dimensions. So I don't know much about space. Just imagine you eating a bite of this, taking you to the 5th dimension.
Look at that yolk, boy. Look at the yolk flip.
Ow, pulled a muscle. let me take you around. You see the camp? So remember how I've been telling you guys about, I don't want to do overnighters here because I've got a lot of dead ash trees that are going to kill me. I did an overnighter. The next night we had a storm and one of my three largest dead ash trees, that's literally right behind camp, one of them, two of them, there was one right there. Big, big old tree. It fell. It uprooted, completely pulled up out of the ground, uprooted and dropped. Luckily, the camp was probably only like, if you're looking at it bird's eye view, like a pie chart bird's eye view, the camp would only take about 10% of the floor space around that tree. So it was a 90% chance that it was gonna fall away. Yep, it ended up falling right there. So, but that was one of the reasons why I was apprehensive about doing overnighters out here. Let's go look at it. See? Look at my foot for comparison. A tree probably 3 feet wide, all the way long. Just dropped. It was a really bad storm though, so I completely would have foresaw that happening. I mean, I wouldn't have been camping on a snow ice storm night like that anyways. But let's take a little hike so you guys can get a feel as to how far in real time my tree house is gonna be from my base camp. Any of you guys that have been watching along on the tree house build series would know that I originally anticipated putting it right here. That is not gonna happen. You see, these trees are about 15 feet apart, which anybody that's built anything would know that 15 feet apart is a big build. You're talking 17 foot timber to be able to span that. So I've opted to go to my other site, which was the smaller of the two sites I picked out. It's probably only 60 yards from the base camp, so it is visible, but you gotta take a little bit of a trek to get back to this corner of the woods. These trees are probably like 7 to 10 feet apart, which is perfect for the strength structure that I need. Where the heck is it? So I came out, made that decision the other day, cleared out some of the, what do you call it, undergrowth, started planting. I don't want to have to do any major trekking to get from one to the other. And I kind of like this area of the woods where my camp is. It's a good part of the woods. Aside from there being so many dead ash trees, it's a really nice little spot. Okay, here's the clearing. Here it is. We're in the clear. I guess that was a stupid way to go. Should have just did a straight shot. So there is my spot, back there. But you guys will see in the near future, this thing going up. So yeah, let's show you guys a little bit more about the spot. All right, so here's the spot. I'm gonna use these three trees as the main supports for it. And these are probably 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 foot. Yeah, for me to be able to span from one tree to the next, over 10 or 12 feet is going to be difficult. That's why I've opted for this setup, this camp right here. I think it's going to be perfect. So now on to the planning phase, now that I actually can take measurements.
When you look at that, it just kind of seems like a good spot for a tree house. Can't you imagine it?
Sorry, I didn't bring a tripod. So anyways, it's probably too dark to see me, but this is gonna be the spot.
There it is, guys. Treehouse is gonna be right there.
I've never done a treehouse build before, and honestly, I didn't grow up building things, so doing stuff like this might seem easy to somebody else, but I'm kind of having to learn as I go, which is fun. It's part of the process of learning stuff. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this little quick video. Getting out to the woods, doing another breakfast. First time I've ever cooked breakfast hash browns. And the key is, I think in my opinion, the key is really getting all the moisture out of the potato. When I grated up that potato, it was so much water inside of it. So I had to squeeze it. And I actually had like 5 little paper towels that I used once I wrung them wrung all the water out of it, I used the paper towels to wrap around it and do kind of the same process. The paper towel would draw moisture out of the potato. But man, hash browns are really good. So it's a simple thing to do to cook potatoes in the woods. You don't have to get a grater like that. And if you do, if you want to do hash browns like that, maybe take a grater like that, take you some 10 snips and snip off the other four quarters, the other three sides. So that way you've got kind of just like a sheet that you could go and prop up against something and slicey up your potatoes. You guys can see I took the tarp off the shelter. I'm gonna be having some renovations here at the base camp. So I decided to take the tarp down from my last overnighter. I appreciate you guys watching that one. I did change the pitch on the shelter, which gives me more coverage from the rain, which is awesome. Luckily, it didn't rain today, because I'd have been out of luck after I took that tarp out. Even though this meal that I cooked had a lot of ingredients, it really was a simple meal. I'm an idiot, and I don't know how to cook. But for me to be able to pull this little breakfast off goes to show that if I can do it, anybody can do it. So why don't you guys get out in the woods, try to cook something up good. All right, guys, well, I'm going to pack up, tear down camp, clean up, put this fire out, and get up on out of here. I appreciate you guys watching. Still watching, you enjoy the video, hit the little subscribe button, click that little bell notification, drop me a little comment, something like that. You know what I'm saying? If not, don't matter. I still love you. Till next time, Scrambled O, signing off.